The overlap. Are you still on your way? Casey! Casey, do you need me?
Fuck. Okay, Saga. Going in solo.
Mom! Logan? Mom, help! Logan! Where are you?
What the fuck was that? Logan's back in Virginia. You're imagining things. What was that? Wait. Did I get turned around? No, this is right. This place is looping. Like a nightmare. He's here. Nightingale. It's like they're coming in over a bad signal. What is this? Who are you?
Hear me.
I'm Saga Anderson, FBI. I can hear you.
Cauldron Lake.
Yes, I'm at Cauldron Lake. Where are you?
I had to escape. In danger. The dark presence.
Danger. Thanks. Got it. Are you okay?
No! It's my fault! They got out with my face scratched!
Sir, calm down. I'm gonna need you to take a breath.
He's changed the story. The dark presence. We must stop it before...
Easy now. First things first. What's your name?
My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer. I've been...
Wake? Where did you come from? You've been missing for 13 years.
13.
Where did you go? All of a sudden, the radio stopped working, and then that flooding just disappeared. A crazy forest. Is this who I think it is?
Casey, say hello to Alan Wake. Mr. Wake, this is Special Agent Alex Casey. He'll escort you to our car. Casey, I'll meet you there, right after I take a look around. If the flooding's receded, there might be evidence we missed earlier.
Okay. See you there.
Alex Casey? How? Am I still... Is this the dark place? No, it can't be. I got out.
Yeah, the PI from your books has the same name as me. Great. Moving on. It's a bit of a hike to the car, Wake. Get your bearings, then we'll head out.
I need another minute. Cauldron Lake. I thought I'd never see this place again.
Take your time, but you should know these woods aren't the safest.
Yeah. It's getting dark. You have a flashlight? It's not safe without a light.
I have a light and a gun. You can relax, Wake.
And pages. If you see pages of writing anywhere, you must take...
Should look around.
Our lives.
With the flooding gone, could be further clues out there. The flooding disappeared very suddenly.
Keep an eye out for
I wonder if there's any connection to the overlap.
Okay, just give
to
me
Nightingale.
A it's okay. Nightingale goes missing for 13 years, shows up murdered, and then turns into a monster. After I stop Nightingale, a rider who's also been missing for 13... finding a Casey movie lunchbox out here can't be a coincidence. Another message?
He'd been on the trail of the writer forever. The writer he despised. Hemingway, Bukowski, Wake.
A creepy twig sculpture? A locked box. Is that the cult of the tree symbol on it? Notes and ammo. Looks like they're tools of the trade. The cult doesn't see their victims as people.
Thank you.
monsters.
Back at Witch's Ladle, Saga pointed the flashlight at the strange, dark substance. The same substance Nightingale had left at the morgue.
There's something written here. A poem? Or a riddle? Reminds me of the nursery rhymes I read to Logan when she was little. A little clothespin doll. Perfect weird souvenir for Logan.
Another one of those rhymes.
Hey there, Mr. Deer. You remind me of a dream I had.
Creepy dolls, mysterious rhymes. No weirder than anything else going on, I guess. These stashes could contain clues about the cult. Better keep an eye out for more. That's not right.
An overlap of the dark place needed a push from both directions to manifest itself. Reality in our world eroded by repeated dark lore tied to a location and a counterpoint. A work of art, a horror narrative crafted in the depths of the dark place, connecting to the story on the other side to reach out through the weakened veil. A story of a lawman whose heart was cut out of his chest. Two corrupt men killed by their own twisted ambition. A haunted old woman drowned in a bathtub. Twisted reflections on the other side of the mirror. Arcs stabbing through realities, amplifying the influence of the dark place. These elements working in conjunction made a trickle that became a torrent, a wormhole, a vortex. And the art, the map, became the nightmare territory where the dark place encroached on our reality. A blanket over it, where they all...
A lunchbox again. Who's leaving these out here?
Thank you.
There's another lunchbox.
Anderson, how's it going down there?
I think I'm done here. I'll meet you at the parking lot.
Ready to go?
Mr. Wake, we're taking you back to our field office in Bright Falls. You can freshen up there, and then we'll talk properly.
Before you say anything, I'm totally fine. Don't freak out. Dad shouldn't have even texted you.
Logan? No one texted me. What's going on?
I'm totally fine. I slipped, that's all. God, it's not the end of the world.
Put your father on the phone.
Okay. Dad, it's Mom.
Don't worry, hon. Logan slipped in the shower and bumped her head. She has a slight concussion, but I'm keeping an eye on her. Lucky I heard her fall. She could have drowned.
Jesus, David. Why didn't you call?
I tried. It didn't go through. She's fine, really. But what about you? You sound stressed.
No, it's a just weird case, that's all.
Well, if you need a hint, my years of board game victories tell me Colonel Mustard did it.
I'll keep an eye out for him. Love you, Dave.
Love you too, honey. Want to say bye to Logan?
Just tell her I love her. Bye for now. Is there anyone you'd like us to reach out to, Mr. Wake? You've been gone a long time.
No. No. They'd be in danger. It'll come for me.
Okay, let's talk about something else. Robert Nightingale. Do you know him? You were both here in 2010.
The Dark Presence got him back then. That's the last time I saw him. 13 years.
Tell us about the pages. You had what looks like a title page with you. Return. Is this the name of the story on these pages? The writer's name has been scratched out pretty violently, but your name can still be made out underneath.
Scratched out. Yeah. Scratch.
Did you write these pages, Mr. Wake?
I'm trying to remember. It's a crazy jumble, like a nightmare. It doesn't make sense.